our week 6 CWL matchup versus the one and only Golden Goblins. Sort of a bit of a heartbreaker war for us. We knew we were going to have to put on our best show. We were aiming for at least 87 stars and fell short of that, unfortunately, because we knew we were going to have to put up a score like that to be competitive in this one, 84 to 88. Overall, Golden Goblins just had a perfect war themselves. They came out and absolutely crushed the nines in like 4 hours. Set up their tens, had a lot of successes up top. So for us though, I mean, our nines kept up. We had no problems clearing, scouted everything up, set our tens up as best we could. We did have some heartbreaking attacks that just sort of too many of them accumulated to just not quite getting enough stars together, and it's unfortunate. But actually, we'll check out some details real quickly, because I know, like, Ice, man, like, 97 and a 96, I'm pretty sure there's a broken tablet involved in that one. Fuck, you know, he deserved those. He put in a lot of planning of those, so I know he's really really upset, falling short on the, those two attacks. Still had a couple other ones in there. Salty, 96% there, 99% by Justin K, 96% by Jacob, like, just... Could have gone anyway, and it did not go our way. So, oh well, is what it is. We do drop to 3-3 in the CWL, and we are absolutely gearing up to make sure that that we try and stay in the hunt here. I know we're still within the hunt with at least two or three other clans right now. I believe WHF2 and Kronos, I want to say. I don't know. Kind of forget, but anyhow, is what it is. I got a lot of attacks to show. I literally just watched all the Town Hall 9 attacks and was trying to figure out which ones I wanted to show. And finally, I just said, you know what? Fuck it. Let's show pretty much all of them. I want to start with Dally Boy here. This was the only Town Hall 9 successful drag attack, I believe. I think. Oh, wrong one. Whoops. He had back-to-back, nice little six-pack there, but this was the attack I wanted to show. Bringing these eight dragons. Sort of interesting base, right up against the edge. I see a lot of guys try and sort of use this technique, throw people off. What I kind of like about it is it just makes for pretty much a no-issue queen, sort of walk all the way down, just getting all these buildings. Idea is to get from air defense number one to air defense number two, and with no trash buildings in the way, kind of on the outside here, he can do that very quickly. He doesn't have to hit that ability early, which is a little unfortunate, but buys his queen just enough time to get out of the range of that expo. And she's going to continue on to take care of that air defense perfectly. So gets this king down with sort of some suicide bowlers. Nice, another third exposed air defense here. Bowlers take care of that, no problem. Basically, that's about all they do. They end up getting another cannon or so over here. King does a lot of work here, though, on this side. He's basically going to clear out all of this trash and leave this nice little pathway just going right through the base through all the rest of these defenses. And obviously, that many dragons are just going to rip through all of that stuff. No air defenses remaining. That little times two. Dragons are going to lock onto those defensive heroes. Down they go. King is still doing work. Little funneling work over there. See what I mean? Like, look at this point. The drags basically just have all defenses, all these juicy defenses they're going to get here. Nice little raid spell. Push them through that stuff very quickly. Queen jumps in to help out at the same time. Looking good. Slow freaking dragons, but doesn't matter. A little preemptive on that wizard. I think he was trying to get it out of the range of that cannon, but doesn't matter. Tree in the bag. Nice job, Dally. Ryan the Great, looking great. Very interesting base. Sort of a forum-ish look to it because of how, you know, this symmetrical design. But very sort of unconventional attack at the same time. It's not like he was just like, this is going to be easy. But by all means, it's not, because he's going to have to bring four golems here and take care of all of this trash on the outside. Just to get into the meat of this base, the idea is take care of this clan castle very quickly, get obviously the defensive heroes on the entry. Huge funnels created. In comes the bowlers, in comes the king. Clan castle's going down. The baby drag takes a little bit of a hike here, but no big deal. Everything's going to work on into this base. Quake goes down, going to open up that very compact area and allow access to pretty much everything in this base. The Golem's going to provide huge tanking. Bowlers are in underneath that rage, looking good. Queen has not been touched, still has a heal spell. He's going to go ahead and drop, I believe, in this core. There it is. Just want to keep the that one or two bowlers or one bowler. Yeah, sorry, two bowlers, I think. In behind that Golem there, well, it's doing crazy tanking from the Expo and both those Teslas. Let's take a bit of a walk. Finally, the Queen steps up, starts taking care of business there. It's going to have to hit that ability here in 1 second. And then come the baby D's to just kind of clean things up. No air defense of threat on that side of the base, so no big deal. Bowler's going to end up taking care of that one on this side. And that's basically all he's waiting for. He's got four cleanup wizards still has that king ability. Drops a couple more wizards to help that king out. Queen steps up, takes care of the archer tower as well. Goes ahead and gets that baby D down. Idea is to make sure he gets that archer tower. And he's looking good. Wizard's going to follow up that king. Everything's going to meet up at 12 o'clock here. And it's going to be a treat. My boy, Ryan. Job. Next on the block, we got my man, Val. Going beast mode on this base. First golem's in at 9 o'clock. Couple wizards down and behind. The usual funneling business going down. Just being very nice and patient on this entry. Finally gets that mortar down, lets the golem step up, and in comes that next golem. He didn't want this golem he was dropping to go to that mortar. He wanted it over here so he could continue to create that funnel off of that elixir storage. It's done successfully. In come the wall breakers and open things up. So he's basically just going to use this L-shaped compartment to walk on over to this compartment with the jump and get access to that queen. King goes in, bowlers go in. The queen does not. The queen takes a bit of a walk, but it's A-okay, because that's sort of where he's directing his troops here. He's just directing them right up to 12 o'clock, and the queen's going to walk up on the outside and do all the cleanup at the same time. So it actually works out absolutely perfectly. Poison spells are down. King goes in there with that ability. Bowlers are going to blast everything from behind. Down go the defensive heroes. Down goes that clan castle. Just got to take care of business on that nasty baby D. Finally, the wizard kills it. Queen steps in and helps out with the shot as well. So here comes the Lalo portion. Coming in from 9 o'clock. A few balloons in straight onto that expo. Nice little haste spell. Second hound in from 6 o'clock. A couple more loons in behind. Very quick on the cleanup mini. I like that, Val, too. Very clairvoyant on those minis at 6 and at the gold store or gold mine over there. Still has that one haste spell to go, but no air defenses remain. All he needs to do is make sure he works through this crazy looking Tesla farm. Drops a couple more balloons to reinforce things over there. Down goes the wizard towers. Looking good at this point. Sweeper given a little. Look at the sliver of health on that sweeper. Was given a little bit of problems, but no big deal. It's really only an archer tower. Little sliver of health as well in that Tesla, but everything going down very beautifully. Clean up all over the place. Just killed it, Val. Nice job, buddy. Oh, the wise man. It's a very interesting base. My immediate thought was, okay, clan castle easily lured. I'll give you a quick poison. My wizard's thoughts on my plan for this base. I wanted to stay away from these air defenses. Because I also noticed these air defenses are both targetable. So for me, because of these sort of healer attacks I use with heavy healers and heavy valks and just keeping things alive, when you give me these air defenses on the outside like that, essentially this 50% bottom half of the base, all my troops are going to be completely safe. Because really the only thing I'm worried about is the air defense targeting my healers. Obviously, you lose a few to mines. But anyhow, so I'm going to bring in this queen here, lure the CC out to her right away. The idea basically was take care of the queen chamber, take care of the clan castle as quick as possible. Now goes that poison. It's always a nasty little clan castle comp. Get that. So I got that raise down early as well. I know as soon as those Valks get in there, it just gets a little bit scary for a moment. But she manages to pull through, takes care of that baby D, locks onto this heavy hit point stuff there. Drop a wizard, I believe, maybe at some point here. Yeah, there it is, to help out just a little bit. I was actually hoping he would step up and take care of this archer tower, but the wizard tower here was in range, so it took him out. But anyways, he took care of that little spell factory, so looking good. Poison was down that queen. Everything's looking A-OK. I managed to preserve my ability here, and I think that was a sort of a really good factor. So I go ahead and drop bowlers with a couple more healers at 9 o'clock. I have been opting to bring two or three even witches on these attacks. And I'm really sort of trying to utilize keeping them alive for almost the entire raid. And you're going to see this kind of happen. So Valks are now in. This huge funnel's created. Everything's going to go right. There's only one spot for them to go now, right? So pretty easily to judge on the pathing here. Knew they were going to break into this first sort of quadrant. And that's sort of why I wanted the witches on the outside to continue to help make sure the Valks path in back into the base. That's exactly what happens. Raid spell done perfectly. Break things on through. Do have one more heal. I'm going to get down here in one moment, I believe, on this back end. Heal, wiser heal. Where is it? Where is it? There it is. I was really just trying to judge where the majority of my Valks were going to go or what was taking the most damage. Might have misjudged that a little bit, actually. I thought the majority was going in here, and that's why I dropped the baby D sort of to follow everything up. But it doesn't matter. At this point, you tell with basically the defensive king, the archer tower, a mortar, and an air D. There's far too much for this base to handle. Look at these witches still doing work from now rounding the bend at 12 o'clock. Just so many troops left. Job, Wiser. Here we go, looking at SB, killing it here, bringing some hogs. I'm finding the hogs a very interesting choice. We're going to see a few hog attacks, actually, as well. Definitely guys are really, really utilizing the strength of Lalo right now. But that does not mean hogs are not good as well. Usual stuff, just getting this funnel created at 12 o'clock. Second Golem doing some tanking, getting that funnel created at 3 o'clock. We're going to go ahead and use this town hall as our anchor to suck everything in past those Teslas and get into this expo chamber. Once he gets into there, we're going to go ahead and start sending in the hawks because he does not see a lot of bomb threats on these outsides. So really, once this defensive queen sort of jumps into the middle, you're going to see how it plays out. But everything looking good, although his queen does take a bit of a hike here. But again, like a lot of times when this happens, it works out. She did her job, and he's got bowlers in there taking the place of the queen, in a sense, with their ranged attack. So everything's working great. So like I said, you're down, goes that defensive queen once it locks onto the troops in that core. And he goes in and starts sending in these hogs, all different angles. Nice job there, SB, recognizing. Make sure you protect your queen so she can continue doing cleanup. And basically two fingers with almost the rest of them at these last couple compartments because there's almost no defenses to go. Once these two archer towers go down, this is now a defenseless base. And it's clean up time. He's got plenty of it. A little swag. Beautiful. Job, SB. Good old Paragon Hunter. I think I showed him in the last CWL recap with... did he bring 10 drags? Someone can confirm that for me. He brought at least 9, if not 10 drags. And I did lie because when I showed Dally's attack, I said it was the only one. And it clearly was not. PH bringing the 10 drag attack. Double Zapquake. See you later, air defense. Beautiful. So... he suicided the king. The idea is he's just getting a funnel created, basically, now. Suicide heroes. Saving the queen here. Just a very, very interesting plan overall. Utilizing this baby D. Whole 12 to 9 section now is basically cleared out. So goes ahead and gets that queen down and start working on those defenses. Looking good. Oh, just did not have to hit that ability right there, but no big deal. Gets the dragons in now right at this queen chamber. Again, using this town hall as an anchor. In goes the hound on this last remaining air defense. And everything's going to look real fine and dandy right here in a minute. Too bad he didn't have a rage at this point. How awesome would that be? But fortunately, with the double Zapquake, he's looking pretty still. Just far too many dragons for this base to handle. Nice little poison spell. But doesn't matter. See you later, defensive dragon. A few little air skellies pop. No big deal. Whoa, one puff. See you later, guys. And the only threat now is his little sweeper giving work to these drags over here in this Tesla compartment. It's a very little deadly compartment, especially for this comp. But these four drags or five drags are going to work to the outside, and he gets just enough drags to go to that compartment and take care of business there. Finally, down goes the sweeper, down goes the Tesla, and goodbye. I'm going to fast forward this a bit. PH just killing it. Oops, hit that a little preemptively. No big deal, though. Right. I believe this was McGrady hitting for Kadok. Really nice little plan here. Goes ahead and gets this first golem in on this mortar. A couple wizards down, getting the funnel created. Wants to get the mortar dead, and then is going to use this section to create the rest of his funnel. Decides to bring a few minions for this outside area to start doing that job. Basically right at the beginning of the raid, which is great. So the next two golems are in. They're just going to work on that mortar while the queen does the job behind. Goes ahead and drops that one-for-one trade on the cannon there. I thought that was really nice as well. Down it goes. So the funnel's created. Nice little job on that. A couple minis in, still working. Oh, I guess he's going to lose one. But I know this minion, I'm pretty sure, does get that mortar to go all by itself. So good trade on that. Raid spells down. Bowlers are in. Poisons are down. All this juicy, juicy part of the base is getting just absolutely crushed by this kill squad. And he still has 19 hawks to go with his very, very, you know, no bomb compartments in the base, right? Like, I talk about this quite frequently. When you see a base with very small compartments, like really exaggerated around the outside, really good spots for hogging. All you got to worry about is spring traps. But there's a fair amount of good spots. Like, as you see, he just lost one there. But the way he's angled the hogs, he's probably never going to lose more than one or two with the way they're taking care of those defenses. Nice little heal spell over that bomb tower as well. But one cannon remaining, it didn't matter. That heal was basically swag. McG killing it for us, buddy. Good job. Good old Flower. Very interesting base, and I will say it's not very often you see Chad Fala bringing 14 hogs, so I thought this was a really cool attack. Again, this sort of business where you bring your base right to the edge of the wall and don't have any trash on the outside. I don't know. It just allows you to very easily do something like this and very quickly also get your troops in. They don't have anything to really work through before they're starting targeting defenses. I know it's just a mortar, but I don't know. I'm not a huge fan. Poison's down over the baby D's. Looking good. Queen's in. She's going to take care of business. Help of that wizard. And the kill squad's going to just smash through this stuff, right? A couple Teslas down. Expo's down. Expo number two is about to go down. Defensive King is about to go down. And still has 14 hogs with a heal for this back end, which is basically just four air defenses and a couple cannons. There goes a bomb, so that's good. Nice little trigger on that. Queen's doing work, couple balloons in. Why not? Although, like I just mentioned, they're all air defenses on this back end. I might have been a little earlier on those hogs, Chatty. I think you could have deployed them a long time ago, but doesn't matter, because you have 14 hogs to basically take out two cannons. That's freaking awesome. Heal spell, wizard to swag, just absolutely crush the base, Chatty. Nice job. Boom. That is a tree in the bag for Flower. Right, who we got next? Pratosh. So, Suicide Heroes with a quad Lalo. I like this one. Tosh getting really good with this. No Zapquakes, none of sort of that business. Just straight Lalo in this base. suicides the stuff in on these defensive heroes. Idea is he really wants to get both defensive heroes, this archer tower, and obviously the air defense, most importantly, and the clan castle. So looking good, right? Everything's down. Looking good. See you later, defensive queen. We're going to go ahead and lock on to that air defense. Okay, so now we got four hounds for three air defenses and 21 balloons. It's really just a matter of pathing and proper deployment and spell deployment. So we're looking good at this point because you can kind of see how the pathing is going to work. So everything's going to work up to 12 and then straight back down in to this deadly part. This is where it gets a little tricky. But at the same token, this is why he brought these raid spells, because you're going to see here in a second, another raid spell is going to go down and just absolutely crush through these parts of the base. Come on, get that down. There it is. There's that rage. So just one-shotting, just bam, 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 moving along through all the defenses. There's very little room for those balloons to travel. There's very not much distance for those balloons to travel. Jesus Christ. but really, that Tesla's about to go down, and there's nothing now that can stop this. these troops. Holy Jesus. Tree in the bag for Tosh. Good job, buddy. All right. Moving on. JP. My boy. Let's go ahead and just bring Shattered Lalo or Bull Lalo. Sort of an interesting base here. I probably would have attacked this differently. But just looking, I mean, you see all or like maybe everything except for that elixir storage. Every single high hit point and that storage, because they're sort of on the outside, but this has every high hit point structure you can have, and then the clan castle. So really, it's all on this side. So JP sort of recognizes this and is like, okay, well, that means my queen is going to get really good freaking value down here. There's only splash damage as well, so he can get away with bringing less healers, and is just looking really dandy at this point, because now he's going to go ahead and drop this golem, work right into this base and come in from the backside where there is very, very, very little little stuff for him to get through. Wall gets opened up. Things are looking good. He's going to have to get that jump spell down here in a moment. And the golem's going to walk right into the core here. Bowler's in behind with that king in behind as well. Poison goes down to help out with the clan castle troops. And the rage goes down to help his troops. And he's just going to smash on through into the backside of this queen chamber. And everything's about to lock onto this defensive queen. Nice little rage spell there as well to help that king out. Beautiful. Just absolutely smashed through very quickly as well through this bottom section of the base and got in through the backside. Took care of that queen. In comes that hound, goes ahead and drops a couple balloons. Didn't really bring many. I think he only brought 10 balloons here, but it's really just few for each defense on the outside, and then they're going to go right to that remaining air defense, and it's going to be GG. Troops everywhere. And a boy, JP. Oh, my, oh, my, oh, my. Sir Cass killing it for us again. Going ahead and bringing a walk with two golems. So that's a very heavy kill squad investment here with 14 balloons and one max hound coming out of a CC, I believe. So no bowlers on this attack. What he's going to what he recognizes is, again, these very sort of exaggerated air defense on the outside. You have access to that stuff. So the idea behind these bases is because they're on the outside, your balloons are going to sort of the lava hounds are going to act sort of strange. They're not going to get really good tanking value, I guess that's what I'm trying to say. Because if they're sitting here on the outside, right, and their defenses knock them, well, none of this stuff in the core is targeting them at all. So once you start sending in balloons, you know, these wizard towers, while they're targeting the lava hounds, the balloons are going to be right on top of them, essentially killing the balloon. So that, anyways. But when you can get really good push into the base like this with this little walk, a couple golems, it's going to basically walk in and take care of all the wizard towers and three air defense. Well, then all you need is a little bit for this back end area, and you're going to look golden. So income a few balloons from this 6 o'clock area while the kill squad's doing the tanking. Good recognition on that as well. You're going to have cleanup all over the base. A little weird Tesla farm. Very little. So in a first hit, that's might even get you a defend, which is nice. But really, with all these troops moving in, the healers are all still alive, right? Because all those air defenses got killed so quickly. And the haste spell is down. And Sir Cass has almost every troop still alive in his army right now. Absolutely crushed it, man. Nice job, buddy. Oh, yeah, Pitt. Thought this was a really good attack. 31 hogs he brings here. Just sort of recognizing the bomb spots, recognizing he's going to get both heroes. He's going to get the clan castle from this very low-cost kill squad. You know, a couple wizards, heroes, golem, you're good. He's going to go ahead and get all of this juicy stuff out of the way. There it goes. Just got to let that queen walk right into this alleyway. I was actually scouting this base when I was trying to figure out who I was going to attack, and I was going to hit it, and the pit called it ahead of me, but I ended up crushing it. So kill squad going in, beautiful job, and let's go ahead and spam 31 hogs from 12 o'clock. And the reason he knows he's okay is because he knows all these hogs are going to be fine under heal spell with only one bomb and defenses. And sends in a few from this section to trigger this bomb, and that's it. He's basically just got to get to this bomb tower, which he does, because these hogs are just melting defenses as they get to them. Down it goes, and down goes that third heal, healing everything up, absolutely killing it. He's got to get through this last section, but guess what? We got another heal. There we go. Keep those hogs alive, and it is G, frickin' G for this base, absolutely. Boom. Job, Pit. Think this is the last town hall night. Robbie, my boy. So very compact. It's kind of a cool base. I sort of like this design because he pushes it right to the wall, but he puts trash out there, and that's what I liked as well. I also liked it. I don't know. I just thought this was a really cool base design. Shout out to Fongavi. But you got a guy like Rob bringing in a very standard Lalo here, and he just recognizes the value of this jump spell right here. This queen's going to jump, and if he gets bowlers in, and his queen is definitely going to need that clan castle. Second jump is down as well. So clan castle's poison. Queen is poison. Everything's dead. Just got to work on that dragon a little bit. Down she goes. Beautiful. We have now got both air defense. We've got the defensive queen out of the way. Things are looking good. His queen sort of taking a bit of a gander and actually wanders up to this third air defense. I don't think he was necessarily planning for that, but awesome. So balloons are in. There's only a few, really two archer towers, a whiz tower that is almost dead, and an expo that can do any sort of damage to this air attack. So there's far too much to go. Balloons are everywhere. He's got cleanup everywhere. He drops a few balloons too to help his queen out. Just beautiful recognition on this attack, Robbie. Save a couple for cleanup. Perfect. I think there's a troll Tesla, but nope. He already took that building out of 12. That is a tree star in the bag. And unfortunately, this is the only 10v10 I get to show. Actually, I'm going to show. Well, we'll show this one. I'm going to show as well. Dennis had a really nice 10v11. That I will finish this recap off with. But you're going to see Alpha here. Go ahead and get these minions down, all out of range. Goes in and gets the golem down. A few wizards in behind just to start taking these buildings out very, very quickly. Earthquakes, the Inferno. I like that. Opens things up for that queen. Sends in the wall breakers on the off spot. Don't think he meant to do that. But doesn't matter. You're going to find out. That is hilarious. I didn't see that Gix when I watched this at first. But no big deal. Everything's going to go in. That because of the earthquake, the king took one smack at that wall and it let everything right in anyway, so it didn't really matter. Queen's working on that hound, and finally it pops. Just needs to get rid of all this crap now in the middle so he can continue working on some of these defenses, and very, very quickly goes ahead and deploys his Lalo. So first hound is in, two balloons on each defense on the outside, a few town hall 9 defenses there, so... just needs two per defense mainly for most of that stuff. Raid spell down over top of the air defense and the expo, so good job there. His loons path perfectly into this Inferno Tower. That is under the free spell, so see you later there. Queen is still doing work up at 12 o'clock. Unfortunately, she is going to die here, I believe, in a second. But no big deal because he's got a billion balloons hasted, working their way through the rest of his base. It's only a matter of cleanup now. And he saves a couple whiz. Archer down for this bottom part. We got some pups down there. Looking good, my man. Awesome. Nice job, Kix. All right, so one more. It's already a like, super long freaking recap. But we got Dennis going in on their number one. Getting a very nice high percentage attack. He's going to be bringing 11 bowlers with a golem, 5 healers, some baby D's to do some work. He even brings a free spell, which I think is really cool. You don't see that a heck of a lot, 10v11. So goes against his walk-in from 6 o'clock. A few baby D's to start doing work already. Getting this stuff down at 6 o'clock. So basically just wants to continue to walk this queen up and around. She's going to continue to do so. Bam, work those stupid skellies. I like the decision to drop that assistance whiz. Unfortunately, I might have dropped it a little further to the left, so it would have followed the queen. But no big deal. Dennis is going to work through the rest of this stuff. Just got to work through this stupid gold storage and then the arch tower. And once he pokes in to this little nook, going to continue to drop some baby drags around 12 o'clock. Continue, he really just wants to basically get percentage now because this funnel's created on this side and start to create a funnel for his king and these bowlers now to join the queen and step up because this, you can see, his queen and the bowlers can reach the town hall from this compartment. But it doesn't matter. It brings a jump spell anyways. But looking good. Already at 41%. Raid spell is down. Eagle cannon is activated, but no big deal. Poison's down over those heroes. Going to work through this stuff, no problem. Down goes that expo. Down goes that max Inferno Tower. Beautiful job. 55%, 56%. Looking good at this point. Queen is about to die here in a moment. But looking good, Dennis. Absolutely crushing it, buddy. Look at the max Inferno. Look how fast it kills these bowlers. Oh. Jesus. Beautiful. 68, you get 69, I think, percent. 70%, I think, you get out of this. Yeah, a couple archers around the outside. Oop. Boom, 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 boom. Nice job, my man. We actually did a really good job overall on their 11s. We cleared them very, very quickly with a pretty decent percent, especially on that number one there. We were happy with that. Just couldn't come through in the end of the day. Tough one. Golden Goblin, shout out. You guys are ridiculous. I think we put up a pretty good fight for the most part. Had some very, very shitty freaking outcomes of some very close attacks. And it's going to happen. So anyhow, I will see you guys next week for our week 7. Who do we have? Oh, I know we got Pigeonism soon. I don't know. I think it might be Pigeonism next week. So guys, until then, that'll do it for your wisdom from Wiser. Just trying to help it bag that next tree start. Till then, I'm out.